Bimmer King. Today we have the all-new F90 BMW M5. We will talk about the exterior, the interior, and of course the infotainment system. This car in particular has the sapphire black color. This is the first time the M5 has the xDrive all-wheel drive system. And thanks to plenty full of aluminum in its construction, it's a lot lighter than its predecessor. For example, the roof is made out of reinforced carbon fiber. The engine is a development of its previous 4.4-liter V8 engine, using the most powerful version used in the 30 Jahre edition as its starting point. This car has a 4.4-liter twin-turbocharged V8 engine and a rear-biased all-wheel drive system. It has about 600 horsepower using an 8-speed automatic with a torque value of about 750 Nm. It goes from 0 to 100 km an hour in about 3.4 seconds and from 0 to 200 km an hour in only 11.1 seconds. The front apron of this car is entirely different than from the normal regular 5 series. For example, it has a lot larger air intakes to suck in as much air as possible. Also, the color of this car is sapphire black, and the headlights are BMW adaptive LED headlight as a standard with laser technology. It has automatic high beam and automatic corner lights. Of course, it has the iconic BMW kidney grille with the competition package, which will come later in April. This will entirely be black, as well as the side breather, which will be black as well. It will also have about 25 more horsepower than this car, totaling at about 625 horsepower. Furthermore, you can see these large air intakes, which look pretty aggressive, and of course the nice looking headlights. Now, let's take a look at the side. First, the hood of the car, which has some nice curves to it. I don't know if you're able to see it clearly, but maybe from this angle you see it better. You can see some nice curves on the hood, which look very sporty, aggressive, and I love these curves. From the side you can see this nice sporty looking breather at the side, and these amazing 20-inch double-spoke light alloy wheels. The black color really adds to the sportiness of this car, with the M emblem below the BMW logo and the blue brake calipers. You can also get the carbon ceramic brake disc as an option, but I would only do that if you want to take it out on the track sometimes. The hood is made out of reinforced carbon fiber to make it lighter, and of course it has the iconic BMW shark fin. From the side you have a line going above the breather all the way to the back, and some small details at the bottom. In my opinion, this car doesn't look too sporty, at least not for a 600 horsepower car, but that's kind of what it makes it so beautiful. It's like a sleeper. Now we're taking a look at the back of the car. These are the M exhaust pipes, and these are worth having. They are a lot sportier looking and they give a lot of better sound. Furthermore, this car has the 360 degrees camera, and here you can see the camera for behind.
There's also one camera under the side mirror. In the front and below we have sensors for the adaptive cruise control.
Apart from all of that, this car has some amazing LED tail lights and of course the M5 logo at the side.
Now let's take a look at the interior. First of all, upon opening the door, I noticed these beautiful blue ambient lighting. Of course I can change this in more colors, but this blue already looks beautiful. And it's a lot brighter than in the older cars. Of course we have the M5 emblem at the bottom and electrical seat adjustments. The steering wheel is made out of leather. This is the M Sport steering wheel, with the pedal shifters behind. Beautiful, with some shortcut buttons on the left and the right. And the M emblem at the bottom. Beautiful stitching on the inside in the M colors. Simply a beautiful steering wheel. Furthermore, this car has a keyless go, so all you have to do is press the button to start. Beautiful carbon fiber on the inside. also some more carbon fiber over there and on many other places in the car to give the luxury some sportiness. Also beautiful stitched leather everywhere in the cabin, as you can see. And down here we have the key. To start the display, you just have to press the button on the side and you can unlock it by simply swiping up. It says the car is open and it's connected. You have a lot of options. You have 413 kilometers radius. You can set the time. And you can even park this car. Beautiful key for this beautiful car. Over here we have the Bowers & Wilkins surround sound system. In the competition edition you will get the Bang & Olufsen surround sound system. Beautiful leather seats with the M5 emblem at the top, which illuminates in the dark. M Sport seat belts with the nice M colors. And let's start the car to see the display. First, you can see the gauge of the car, which is completely digital, beautiful, and you can customize them a little bit. Starting the display, you can see the driver profiles, and I will now show you how you can change them. First, you click on change name, then you of course delete everything, and you fill in your own name. You can then customize a lot of things about this car. You fill in your entire name, and when you're done, you press OK, and there you have it. Gesture controls in this car, of course. Always a lot of fun to play with, but in my opinion, the shortcut at the steering wheel is a lot easier to change the sound. Here we have the navigation, of course, with a lot of information such as where the patrol stations are. You can use the hardware controller to go back to the main menu, or you can use the touchscreen, and you can even use voice commands here at the steering wheel. Very useful. Now let's see what we have. We have the connected drive, which shows you some live information such as news, weather and online searches and wiki local. In the My Car you have all the settings for your car. Here at the car settings you have the lighting for the interior. This is for the ambient lighting, as you can see. Here, let's change it into orange, for example. Beautiful. And you can see that the Bowers & Wilkinson surround sound system also illuminates. We change it into white, blue again, and you have all these colors. I personally like the green. And here you have a better look at the Harman-Kardon surround sound system. But you have a lot of options. But let's put it back to blue, because this looks the brightest. Here you have the settings for the Bowers & Wilkinson surround sound system. And of course the exterior lighting, where you can change the light indicator settings. Furthermore, we have the intelligent safety, some speed limit assist, a lot of things, even parking. Now, let's go back. And we see the seat comfort, where we have the driver's seats, the front seats, and we even have massaging seats. And these are seriously amazing. So let's first turn it on one. And now we have the full body massage. You can also change it to upper body. You can put it higher. But for now, let's turn it off and move on. Now let's go back to the menu and let's see what we have in the iDrive settings. Here we can connect your mobile devices, change the language, but we even have wireless charging. You can put your phone somewhere here and it will wirelessly charge it. Now let's see, we even have some settings for the head-up display, which this car of course has. Over here you have the projector. You can fully customize this, of course. I personally like the M view. So let's put it on the M view, of course. And you have the control display. Instrument combination. And lots more. So let's see what else. We can change what we see in the main menu. And at the connected drive, let's turn on the news so we see how it works. Of course, there's your driver profiles. Here you have the technique of the car in the efficient dynamics and the sport display. So here we see the news. So it seems to work. If we press this button, we enhance the exhaust sound, and if we press this, we see the 360 degrees camera. You can move it around with the hardware controller and even with gesture controls. But for the gesture controls, you have to be very specific, because if you put your hand in a different position, it doesn't work. Only in this way. Beautiful. And with these buttons, we can configure the mode of the car. We can change it from comfort to sport or sport plus. This is for the steering wheel, but you can change it for the other things as well. Let me show you how to turn off four-wheel drive. First you press this button and you see DSC is on. Then you press it for a couple seconds and it will say M dynamic mode. Now just press it for a couple seconds and you have M X drive configuration. You can put it from four-wheel drive to four-wheel drive sport and two-wheel drive. Four-wheel drive sport favors the rear-wheel drives more and two-wheel drive is only rear-wheel drive.
So what do I think about this interior? It's a very luxurious interior and the materials and the quality of the interior is very hard to criticize. It gives you a lot of space and this is of course a very large car. The seats, they are extremely comfortable, especially with the massage seat options. And it feels like you've been caught in a baseball mitt because you sit so comfortable and it wraps around you like you can see here and here. So the interior and especially the front seats, they get an A+ for me. Now, we have seen everything about the interior. The last thing we can see is the space here. And of course, there's some extra space over here. And finally, over there with a cup holder. So now we have seen the exterior and the interior from the front. What we haven't seen yet is the back of the car. So we will go and see if we have enough space in the back and if this car can be seen as a family car. So let's go.
What I first noticed was these rear windows. They are so black that I can't even look through them. But let's go inside. From the back you also have the ambient lighting in the blue color. And of course the M5 logo when you get in. Beautiful Bowers and Wilkins surround sound system, nice carbon fiber, and a beautiful view at the front. In the back you have the M Sport seat belt as well, with the beautiful M colors. Some hardware controls for the comfort in the back.
So in the back we also have enough space. As you can see, I have more than enough space with my legs, more than enough headroom.
It also gets an A+. There's nothing to criticize about these back seats, and you can easily see this as a family car. So if you have just gotten children, I would advise get a car like this, because it's still sporty, it's still amazing. It goes from 0 to 100 kilometers an hour in only 3.4 seconds, and it fits more than enough people. And now we have seen the back of the car, the interior and the exterior. And finally, let's check the cargo space of the car to see if we have enough space there to go on holidays. So let's go.
Again, we have the beautiful key with a display. And to open the trunk, you simply press and hold this button. Awesome. Now let's see the cargo space. It seems very spacious. Definitely enough space to go on holidays and fit a few suitcases. But what I do notice is down here, you can't open this. It's solid and it's stuck. But yeah, there's more than enough space to go on holidays. Definitely, and it sure is a very large car. To close the trunk, you can either press this button, but it's cooler to just press and hold the key. A cool trick with almost any car is when you press and hold the open button. So that was the video for today. I hope you guys liked it. If you liked it, please subscribe to the channel and maybe like this video. It even helps to just share it around. And I hope to see you guys next time on the next video. Goodbye guys, see you later.